Hotel, hotel, free the land, black laws for all black people. This is a video response to that video Seti did, banging on them Hebrew Israelites. And I found out, man, that this, like Seti said, man, this is that Assyrian division, right? Where they cut us up in many pieces and scatter us all over, right? So we gotta find a way to get back together as whole, right? I love all my black people, you know what I'm saying? And if you study the great teachers, you will understand that the black man is a Moor. The black man is a Hebrew. The black man is the Jew. The black man is the Christian and the Muslim. We are all of that. But we want the origin and we want the truth. We want the root. It ain't about hating and wanting to fight one another, man. But Hebrew Israelites, man, they stuck up on this Bible, and all Seti asked them was for a date. You know what I'm saying? Give me a date, but they couldn't supply a date. The brother couldn't supply a date. He asked for a date. He ducked and dodged, went all around, and would not give him a date. You know what I'm saying? Give me a date of the time of Avram or Abraham or Aram or whatever you want to call him. But they ducked and dodged, and I noticed that the brothers kept going to the Bible, right? But before I get off into this really thick and go into this damn Bible, I want to read a passage from The Miseducation of the Negro by Carter G. Woodson. Carter G. Woodson said, way back in 1933, the education of any people should begin with the people themselves. Again, the education of any people should begin with the people themselves. And in the first chapter, it reads, the educated Negroes have the attitude of contempt toward their own people because in their own, as well in their mixed schools, Negroes are taught to admire the Hebrew of the cracker, the Greek, the cracker, the Latin, and the Teuton, Peckerwoods, and to despise the African. Seti banged on the Moors who hated the African. He just banged on these Hebrew Israelites who hate Africa, who gives no respect to the Kemasians, where civilization began, right? Where some of the greatest civilization was at, right? But Seti, he pretty much covered all that. But the brothers kept going to the Bible, right? And I've noticed one thing, just pick up this Bible and give it back to them, you know what I'm saying? But I can't go by this Bible. This Bible, I say, is the blueprint to maintain white power and control of the masses. Simply, we can go to the book of Joshua, right? 10:12-13. In this verse, it speaks of a book called Jasher, right? There's many books that were in the Bible, right, that were taken out. You know what I'm saying? So-called lost books of the Bible or whatever. Who took them out? Right? Who lost them and who found them? So, in Joshua, it speaks of how this battle was going on, right? And God made the sun stand still for a whole day while this battle was being fought. And once the battle was won, he made the sun move again. Now, the sun is 93 million miles away. Heaven is on top of that. And God is above all that. Right, so you mean to tell me that God can't look down and see that the goddamn sun is standing still? Hell, I can make the sun stop and stand still because it's already motionless. You know what I'm saying? It's not moving around the damn planets. The planets are what moves around the sun. The sun is what gives it that the energy to move around. But there are many books spoken of in this Bible, right? But the books ain't in this Bible. How come there ain't no book of Egypt? How come there ain't no book of Ethiopia? Right? There were great men in this Bible that learned in Egypt, that went to Egypt. It was Abraham who went to Egypt with his wife. Right? He told his wife to tell the king that that she was his sister. Right? This motherfucker was finna prostitute his wife off to the king. That ain't the nature of the black man and the black woman. right? But you want me to take this Bible as fruit and feed it and eat it and feed it to my kids. That ain't gonna happen. How come there's no book of Jesus, right? Moses was learned in Kemet. Jesus was hidden in Kemet to keep him being killed. From birth to 12 years old, he was in Kemet, right? So he had to learn, so he was learning well in Kemet, right? But there's no book of Egypt, there's no book of Ethiopia, there's no book of Africa, right? But the very ones that killed the revolutionary Messiah, Yahshua ben Yosef or Yahshua El Pantera or Yahshua Christos, they get a book in the Bible. Romans. Romans got a book, and the Romans killed God's only begotten son, and they get a book in the Bible. And I'm going to read to you what it says. I'm trying to wrap this up. I only got 10 minutes. Chapter 13, verse 1, right? It says, let every soul be subject to the governing authorities. Let every soul, and we speak of soul, like the Moor said, we want etymology. We want root of these terms. Soul, in its etymological term, comes from the word sol, S-O-L, which means sun, right? So here they talk about them sunburnt people, right? Every soul, white people ain't got no souls. They have a spirit and an evil, wicked spirit, but they don't have a soul, right? You have to get some of this sun to be able to have a soul. But anyway, let's move on. Let every soul, every nigga, be subject to the governing authorities, for there is no authority except from God, and the authorities that exist are appointed by God. God appointed the Romans authority over the niggas, over everybody at that time, when these motherfuckers killed his son? And you want me to believe this? Oh, no, no, I can't do that. Therefore, whoever resists the authority resists the ordinance of God, and those who resist will bring judgment on themselves. For rulers, the Roman Gentile Jews, are not a terror to good works, but to evil. Do you want to be unafraid of the authority, the Roman Gentile Jews? Do what is good, and you will have praise from the same. For he, Caesar, the Romans, is God's minister to you for good. But if you do evil, be afraid, for he does not bear the sword in vain. For he is God's minister and avenger to execute wrath on him who practice evil. Therefore, you must be subject not only because of wrath, but also for conscience sake. For because of this, you also pay taxes, for they are God's ministers attending continually to this very thing. Render, therefore, to all their due. Taxes to whom taxes are due. Customs to whom customs are due. Fear to whom fear. Honor to whom honor. You want me to believe this? I can't do it. This book is not for me. It's not for my babies. I can't give my people this book and tell them that this is the inspiring words of God. You can have this shit. I don't want it. Because all it's doing is destroying our people. Just like Carter G. Woodson said, man. The education of any people should begin with the people themselves. We got to start educating ourselves. And in Naeem Akbar's book, Know Thyself, right? It says, an analogy that we may use by looking at a lower animal like a dog give us an idea of the difference between training and education. The dog that learns to bark, to scare away its enemies, predators, to defend itself by biting its attackers, and to hunt and to feed itself is an educated dog. See, that's me. That's Seti. That's Sarnetta. Right? That's RBG. You know what I'm saying? We'll bite your ass if you attack us. We ain't got time for these crackers and they bullshit, right? The dog that learns how to stand on his hind legs and wear a dress and dance to the music of his trainer is actually a trained dog, right? There's many trained dogs out there that's being hand-fed by their master, by this old wicked beast. Man, you can, I tell you, you can roll with us or roll with the beast. You can get on the bus or get beneath our motherfucking feet. Right, because I ain't got time for this cracker, man. I ain't got time for nobody to bring me this cracker's bullshit, okay? Because my enemy wears all white, even when he's naked. If I stump my toe, I'll blame it on that goddamn white man. Black power.